有亵渎的名号，意思说他是全然的败坏邪恶。
Now some of the commentators think that maybe it is, they might refer to the pagan religions who claim divine authority but don't have it.
还有的解经家做这样的解释。似乎也有道理，是说这每一个头是意思是什么？在这个世界上有很多其他的稀奇古怪的这种异教的这种宗教信仰，他们都宣称他们的神是至高无上的神，但实际上都不是。所以呢，这些头呢，实际上是上面就写满了亵渎神的名号。
Then it speaks about he has a head that was that was killed, and then it was healed.
在第三节我们看见说，这个七个头当中有一个似乎受了死伤，后来那死伤又被医好了。
And the the Bible doesn't explain anything. It doesn't give a direct explanation of it.But we can come to this conclusion.
关于这个头，这一个头受了伤，后来又医好了这件事，圣经没有直接的交代。但是呢，我们还是可以做一定的解释。
Maybe Satan will make a parody on Jesus' death and resurrection.
比方说，撒旦可以在耶稣的这个死和复活的问题上做一点文章。
You see.The greatest thing ever happened in this world was Jesus Christ died and then rose from the dead.
比方说耶稣，这实际上在人类历史当中，没有耶稣的比耶稣的死和复活更伟大、更重要的事情。
And Satan knows the impact that had on the world.
那几千年来，这个撒旦也很知道耶稣的死和复活对这个世界的冲击的程度是前所未有、无与伦比的。
And so when he brings his man in, he says, okay, he has to have an impact on the world. And so he copies what happened.
那所以很有可能撒旦会做一件事情，就是把这个兽从海中招上来以后，他心想耶稣死而复活可以冲击这个世界，我如果让他也行同样的事，死了或者又后来又活了，那么这个事肯定能轰动世界。
And what John says here is that what he saw was the result was that the people of the world were tremendously amazed.
根据这个老约翰的记载，在十三章的第三节的后半节说，全地的人都稀奇这头兽，然后就跟从这头兽。
They seemed to come to the conclusion that he was invincible.
所以呢，似乎他们得出一个结论，就是这个人一定铁定无疑就是神了。
Because they said, "Who can stand against him?"
因为他后来说，你看他谁可以与他交战的？在第四节的后半节说。
And now we go back to verse 2, and the beast had 10 horns with crowns on them.
在第二节是讲前面讲到有十个，这第一节说有十个冠冕，七个头上，十脚上戴了十个冠冕啊。
Now horns, being a symbol of strength.
这个角呢是一个象征这个权柄和能力。
Would indicate that the beast had tremendous power.
这也是在表明一件事情，这头兽是有大而惊人的这种能力。
So there is someone coming who's going to have tremendous power.
所以这一个要来的这头兽，将具备一种了不起的这种能力。
Going to be greater power than Stalin had.
这个人的权力将一定会超过苏联的斯大林。
Or Hitler had.
或者是希特勒这样的权柄。
Or Mao had.
或者毛泽东所有的权柄。
And but this because his influence is going to be on the whole world, not just one country.
因为什么呢？因为这些人都只是影响一个国家、一个地区。但是呢，这个将来要来的这头兽呢，它要影响全地，全世界人都要受它影响。
But what John is implying here is that it is something terrible to our imagination.
但是呢，约翰后来就记载了一些东西是非常的可怕，这个恐怖的事情是超越我们人的想象。
But it's interesting here its power and throne and authority were not his own. They didn't come from himself.
在第五节讲的非常有意思的是，这种权柄，他所拥有的权柄不是他自己有的，是被赐给他的。
They were given to it by the dragon.
那这个权柄是谁赐给他呢？是那龙赐给他的。
And evidently, the people of the world will be aware of this that he got it from Satan.
很显然，就是这个能力是由这个撒旦从龙那里被赐给兽，好像似乎全地人都知道。
Because it said that because of that power, they worshipped the dragon.
因为在第四节说，他们又拜那龙。你看，他又前面的是稀奇的跟从那兽，到第四节说又拜那龙。所以呢，他们是知道这个兽之所以有这个大能力，是因为龙给他的。
That's what verse 4 says.
第四节说。
And they worshipped the dragon because he gave his authority to the beast. And they worshipped the beast, saying, "Who is like the beast, and who is able to wage war against him?"
所以在第四节看，人拜龙也拜兽，他怎么说呢？他说，全地的人又拜那龙，因为他。就是因为龙将自己的权柄赐给了那兽，这个全地的人也拜兽，说谁能比这兽呢？谁能与他交战呢
？You see, but now life will be going on in this world the same as ever.
这个世界上的人还是照样这样的生活下去。
The airlines will still be flying people around the world.
这个世界上的航空，这个航线还是飞机还是照飞。
The supermarkets will still be selling food at terrible prices.
那个时候，这个商店里面还是一样有东西卖，只是可能价钱就惊得离谱了。
911 will still, you can still call 911 and the fire engine will come out.
你还有是会有这个火警电话打，那个如果有什么情况，这个火警的车会来。
But there is someone who's going to have tremendous power, who's in authority, whose authority goes over the borders of the countries.
但是呢，那个时候的人呢，到处就要过自己的国家的边界。那个时候，全地的人有一种非常不寻常的一种举动。
Now, when and at that time, these people are going to worship the dragon and they're going to worship the beast.
那个与众不同的情况是什么呢？地上的人不但会拜着兽，他们也拜这个龙。他们拜了龙，也拜兽，所以这个龙和兽是他们同时拜的。
And this is what Satan wants.
那这就是撒旦要达到目的。
He wants worship.
他想要人敬拜他。
See, he told Jesus he would give. Remember, he told Jesus he would give him the whole world if he would bow down and worship him.
大家记得圣灵把耶稣引到旷野以后，撒旦引诱他，其中一个引诱，撒旦跟他讲：“你若拜倒在我的脚下，我就把万国的荣华都赐给你。”
But this beast was given the way that that John writes it. He was given a mouth to boast. Given mouth to the beast to speak arrogant words and blaspheme against God.
在第五节，大家看见说，撒旦又赐给兽说夸大亵渎话的口，又有权柄赐给他。
Now you see, and John in First John, he brings out that the spirit of Antichrist is already in the world.
大家记得在约翰一书里面，约翰说。他说敌基督已经在这个世上了。
And we have heard what Stalin has said, we've heard what Hitler said.
我们听到斯大林说了一些话，我们听到希特勒说了一些话。
And when he was coming far, he says he was given the job to eradicate Christianity.
他们这个撒旦会给权柄给一些人，他最后的这个这个矛头要针对基督，就是神的孩子，基督的教会。
He says, there are Christians and there are Germans, but there is not a Christian German.
他说呢，这个世界上有基督徒，这个世界上也有德国人，但是呢，没有一种是德国的基督徒，没有。
To say a German is Christian, he says that's contradicting each other.
他说当你说他是德国人，但是他是个德国的基督徒的时候，这是一个矛盾的概念。